The sudden death matches continue here at the Sydney Football Stadium in this year's Winfield Cup Rugby League competition. This afternoon, the second of our elimination semi-finals for the weekend sees two of the glamour teams of the comp go into battle, the Brisbane Broncos up against the Sydney Bulldogs. Of course, yesterday, Cronulla made an early exit in a nail-biter, the hands of the Knights. Newcastle now go on to face Manly. This afternoon's winners booked a berth against the reigning Winfield Cup premiers, the Canberra Raiders. There's been a lot of speculation as to what the starting lineups would be for these two teams. Players desperate to get on the field at this end of the season. And Paul Vaughton, take us through the news from the camps of both of these lineups.
Be good news for Brisbane fans with Alan Langer. He's passed the fitness test this morning and will play. And as far as the Broncos are concerned, he is going onto the field fully fit. As for Terry Madison, he will play as well. So great news for the Broncos fans. Julian O'Neill, Michael Hancock, Steve Renoff, plenty of great players there. And the list continues. Kevin Walters, Langer, Lazarus, and some muscle up front with Gavin Allen and Wendell Saylor and Terry Madison, of course, in the back row, coached by Wayne Bennett. And Pete, for the Bulldogs, also some good and bad news. Matthew Ryan has come in for the injured Glenn Hughes. But on the bench, Jason Smith will come from the bench as a fresh player. And that's good news, for he's been out for 3 or 4 weeks. A strong-looking outfit as well. Plenty of speed on the wings with Dallas. And Jason Hetherington has been in good form in the hooking role. And Dean Pay has probably been their best player of the past couple of weeks, Pete.
Yeah, the only hiccup for the Broncos, Andrew G, won't be coming off the bench. He hasn't recovered in time. It's been a funny season for the Brisbane's opposition this afternoon. The Bulldogs really have been fairly inconsistent this year. A lot of people tipping the fact they wouldn't make the top eight. I caught up with their coach, Chris Anderson, only moments ago and just asked him what effect last week's win over the Dragons has had on his football team.
I think the fact that we got over St George, I think St George was an important game for us on a credibility scale. A lot of people said that we were lucky to be in the semis and to win a good tough game against St George has given us a lot of confidence. So I think from now on we're certainly underdogs, so whatever happens bears well for us. So the pressure's off us and well and truly on the other sides.
Brisbane have had some problems, notably the injury worries about Langer and Madison. Are you able to target blokes like that in these kind of games?
I don't think so. Not against Brisbane, certainly. They've got too many good players to target one or two players. Alfie's certainly their game breaker, but the forwards have got to do the work for Alfie to do well. So, our big thing is to try and stop their go forward and to cut down the amount of time Alfie has with the ball.
Yeah, very relaxed, Chris Anderson. And we saw Wayne Bennett as well before the game, talking about Alan Langer. He said that he is not going into this game carrying any players.
That's right, Pete. Look, I think Brisbane can win this and win it quite well. Too much strike power for mine. The likes of Steve Renoff and Wendell Sale on the back row has been an absolute revelation for them. I think Brisbane, Pete.
Yeah, so I'm going to go for a Brisbane victory as well. They've had so much success here at the Sydney Football Stadium in the past, they always seem to lift their game when they come south of the border. Another good semi-final coming up, another elimination semi-final. Let's now go to the kickoff for the match between the Broncos and the Bulldogs.
And Alan Langer takes the Brisbane Broncos out. They've lost only two semi-finals of their last nine. And the second of those came only last Saturday night. A star-studded lineup. Brisbane are out there now. They're G'd right up and Canterbury. The Bulldogs take the field now. Matthew Ryan's in the centres, you know that. Terry Lamb plays 326 today. This could be the end of the great Terry Lamb rugby league career. Steve Roach is on the sidelines.
Yeah, similar conditions to yesterday, Ray. Brisbane have won the toss and will be running from left to right on your screen. They're going to try and take a little bit of pressure off Alfie Langer and not use him as a kicker in general play. That job will go to Julian O'Neill. The Doggies see no expectations from them. I think you'll see the same game as they did last week against the St George Dragons and try and bustle them out of it.
Sun shining down again on the Sydney Football Stadium. Would dearly love some rain, but of course, football viewing at the Sydney Football Stadium, this is ideal. David Manson's in charge. A battle between David and Eddie Ward for the grand final. Fortnight today. Darryl Halligan will kick off. The Bulldogs running from right to left. And Brisbane with first use of the football as Julian O'Neill comes back to be met by the defence and pulled down. 15 metres away from their own line. They clashed once this year at ANZ Stadium, and Brisbane won that, 13 points to 8. Broncos then with Alan Langer in the run-on side, 32 metres away on the first set of six. Michael Hancock comes in and lends his support to the forwards as they come towards the halfway line. Here's Lazarus. Lazarus met and forced down by the Bulldogs forwards, and that stunned Lazarus. He was a bit slow in getting up. We'll watch him closely. Yes, he was wounded by the tackle. As Brisbane clear now, the ball bouncing down inside the 10-metre line and beyond. And the very fast Brett Dallas is looking for some space on the way back.
And Glenn Lazarus is still down on his haunches as Darryl Halligan comes off his wing, centre field, 12 out from his own line. Very good kick from Julian O'Neill, but some concern about the big front rower. He's hit by three in this tackle, and the initial impact was a beauty from Dean Pay.
The Sydney Bulldogs now getting a feel of the football for the first time, and Jim Dimmick clears down with O'Neill. A lot of work to do as he scurries across. He's obliged to pick it up. Brett Dallas put a good chase on it for the Sydney Bulldogs. They come across to Michael Hancock. He runs into a strong tackle, but still able to unload. And Renoff it is now, 38 metres away from his own line. So it's been a very solid start, particularly by Canterbury Bankstown. They've hit Brisbane with some bone-jarring tackles. Lazarus still getting some attention, and here's the first penalty going to Brisbane.
And the longer Lazarus is down, it really must buoy the chances of the Bulldogs. They'd really be excited to see him down. I'm looking at Lazarus, I think he's got a sternum problem.
Let's go down to the sidelines and see if Steve Roach has got any more news on Glenn Lazarus.
Yes, it looks around that sternum area. If you remember back last year, Glenn Lazarus had a cracked sternum for most of the season, so that's not good news for the Broncos.
Alan Langer just went across to inquire as to how Glenn Lazarus was, and the big man is being taken off.
I'm sure he had an operation on that sternum, didn't he? So that's a shocking blow to the Broncos as Wendell Saylor gets his arms free. Tremendous take from Alan Langer, who keeps it alive to Cairn.
So players down on the 30-metre line of Lazarus. He is assisted from the ground. A big blow to Brisbane's chances of winning this one ultimately. And the loose ball is cleaned up there by Gavin Allen. So his workload now increases significantly. He takes on more responsibility. As Walters plays it now just outside the 20-metre line, his brother runs it, then Langer. Langer tries to go through the gap. And the ball came loose, but he got it back in, knocked backwards. Five tackles gone. Just inside the 20-metre point as O'Neill puts it high into the air. Dallas is underneath it. It's a leap for the ball. Hancock! Hancock! He gets it down. It's a try scored by Brisbane's Michael Hancock.
Well, Julian O'Neill has taken over the kicking duties, as Steve Roach pointed out, and his first two kicks have been pinpoint. This one, a tremendous kick for his winger. Looked as though Hancock was onside. He had the momentum. Left high, didn't get it with his first grab, but was able to get control of it before it left his grasp, and scores wide out. They've lost Lazarus, but they've got the first try.
It's a big play, isn't it, to try and isolate the winger, which they've done on Brett Dallas. Two or three Broncos coming down. Hancock, the main one, and he just got the better leap and the juggling act at the end of it. They've done that with 12 men for the first 5 minutes of the match. Lazarus, I think, has gone up in the tunnel with the doctor, maybe to look at the proposition of maybe having a needle into that damaged area, as he hasn't been replaced as yet.
Gus Gould, the kicking game, just unbelievably important in the modern game, and especially this final series so far.
Yeah, it has been. I mean, it's a great skill used by most clubs now. The advantage is really with the attacking player. They're coming from well back, and the momentum to leap high. The defending player standing underneath the ball can't raise himself as high. You've really got to try and run those runners, the chasers, off the ball and give him a little more time and a little more protection.
You just saw that Lazarus. He did get hammered, didn't he?
He did. He seems to be holding his stomach area. Very reminiscent of probably a lower rib cartilage or something right down the bottom there under that short rib, because he's holding it down very, very low. He has had sternum problems, but you know, normally he would play on with that. That's something that he's played with that discomfort many times. I think he's a little worried about his stomach at the moment.
There's the kick from O'Neill, coming around and just wide. So Brisbane, they take first points. They lead Canterbury by 4 points to nil.
And Halligan it is to go through the motions again. Wendell Saylor it is now. Brings it back to the 20-metre line. Saylor in the back row, as he has been for several weeks. Now, Brett Green is the replacement for Glenn Lazarus. Brett is playing in jumper number 30, and we've been advised by the Brisbane dressing room that it is ribs and not sternum the problem with Glenn Lazarus. Phil Gould has forecast that correctly. He was clutching more around the stomach area. Here's the try scorer, Hancock, playing it on five. They go across now for the clear from O'Neill. The ball bouncing up on the 30-metre line. Some trouble here for Silva. And then he's put on the end of the shoulder and driven by Darren Smith. Now for Brett Dallas. He's working off his 30-metre line, trying to work through the middle of the forwards. But Allen is there to make the tackle with Darren Smith. And now the lock forward, Jim Dimmick, with the hair closely cropped. Now to the right, to the blind side, goes Gillies. He links up with Darren Britt. And Britt has put away 5 metres into Brisbane's area. 4-0 in favour of Brisbane. A try off the bomb. Here's Dean Pay standing, offering Hetherington the opportunity. Then Dimmick puts it on the boot. And here's a run back for O'Neill again. He'll have to pick it up and bring it out. He does that. And they put the defence on him. And Dimmick, who kicked the ball, was first there.
It's a big blow for Brisbane losing Glenn Lazarus at this stage of the game. Of course, Andrew G was to be on the bench. He was ruled out with injury yesterday. And that was my concern with Brisbane. I didn't think they played all that well against Canberra last week. Here's a chance, though, down the right-hand side.
Big pass by Langer. Khan's away. But Halligan. Halligan with blistering pace there. Pulled him down. Langer now to the halfway line.
Ball's knocked down by the Bulldogs.
Well, that's incredible, isn't it, that Willie Khan would get run down by Darryl Halligan. They had a foot race over 100 metres. You'd probably back Khan every day of the week. And he had a couple of metres head start. But that's great determination by Darryl Halligan.
Isn't it great football too from Brisbane? In fact, they're prepared to throw the football around there. Tremendous pass from Alan Langer. Terry Lamb feeding that scrum. Polamana going out to 5-8. Tackle on the halfway mark. But he's found a metre, Halligan, all right.
Sure has. Just getting back to that replacement, Ray. Young fellas like Darren Lockyer and this Brett Green, they're good young players, but they really don't have the semi-final experience of the players they're replacing. That was my concern with them last week. I think that's a huge loss, Lazarus, if he doesn't come back out onto the field.
Now, Gillies it is who plays it. They've got a very big back line, wide and deep out to the left. The Bulldogs, as Hetherington goes into dummy half. That's the way they're coming. Through land. On it comes now. Dimmick gets inside the 20, got a pass away for Timu to ground and backwards, I thought. But he's ruled knock on.
Very, very good, Jim Dimmick, at taking the ball to the line and getting the arms free. He's a player who doesn't pass much before the line. He'll take the defence on, and then the uncanny ability to get arms free and short balls around the corner. And players sweat on that. Very hard to defend against, but it will come up with some loose ball at vital times as well.
Darryl Halligan agreed with me. I saw him ask the question of the touch judge. And I tend to agree with Darryl that ball did not go forward as Brisbane go wide quickly. And they're not frightened to go wide inside their own 20-metre line. And that was what Willie Khan was on the end of just a few seconds ago. This is Michael Hancock now with Bulldogs trailing 4-0 as Kerrod Walters puts Alan Langer into a gap. Langer 26 metres out from his line now. As Green, the fresh man on for Glenn Lazarus, repeating that Glenn was injured, unable to continue this far in the first set of six for Brisbane. Now Wendell Saylor on the fifth tackle as they go to Langer on the left of the ground. A little chip and chase. Manson got turned around in the middle of the landing area. And Rod Silver comes away for the Bulldogs. It goes on and away from Ryan out to Dallas. Hancock's after Dallas. And Dallas is rounded up by Hancock.
Yeah, good work there by Michael Hancock too. Dallas, one of the quickest players in the competition. Ryan having a few problems at dummy half. The Bulldogs go wide. We just saw then Alan Langer wanted to kick the ball long. He had to go for the short option.
Penalty against the Brisbane markers, the Brisbane tacklers. And the Bulldogs, with Halligan in the side, will shoot for goal from 35 out directly in front.
Both sides are showing their preparedness to go wide with the football straight away and early in the tackle count. Probably a good idea at this level of football to do it quickly and do it early. Defences know so much about each other. Once you give them a couple of tackles to get organised, they can pick up on the important players in the opposition side. The best time for these two sides to attack is very early in the tackle count. And Brisbane are probably one of the best exponents in the league.
Just going a little bit further with that comment about Alan Langer's kicking game. It seems to be the area that is troubled most by his injury. He can run the football okay, but kicking is a no-no. So we're only going to see Alan Langer kick short in this game. He is very dangerous in that department.
Shot and it's there. 2 points. We're slowly wobbling offline, but it's there. Brisbane 4, the Bulldogs 2. 11 minutes gone.
Everyone smile and get set for the laugh of your life
to the halfway.
On your run.
As you people taking this elimination semi-final, watches live. And watching at the ground, probably a crowd in the area of 32,000.
Oh, here's a tragic mistake made.
Well, you come back to us with a mistake made in goal. Here it is on the replay. And it means that the Bulldogs will restart with a line dropout. Dallas, an embarrassing situation for the youngster. The drop kick is good. Saylor marks it and takes it back. Saylor there, met by a barrage of Bulldogs defence from Darren Britt and also Jason Hetherington. Now this is Green. He ran into the shoulder of Dean Pay. Pay is hitting very, very hard. Totally committed Dean Pay. We've seen in the last couple of weeks. Now in the centre of the park, 30 metres out from the Bulldogs line, through Langer and Walters, they go out looking for Smith and finding him. And then Khan channels back in, and he's brought down 15 metres away from the Canterbury line. They go across with a long pass to Langer. Equally long, it goes along the line, and Renoff unable to take it. Madison's pass was long and down around the bootlaces.
It was the right idea, Renouf. Had Polamount beaten on the outside there if he takes it at full pace. Pass just going astray, however. Polamount defending outside his centre on the right-hand side of the field. Obviously, great respect for Steve Renouf's ability on his opposing centre. Matthew Ryan having his hands full, getting great assistance out there from Craig Polamount.
That's a move they came up with last year in their finals run through to the grand final, using Polamount basically at outside centre in defence. Being employed again against a team that loves to throw the football wide.
Simon Gillies now, and Hetherington goes away from dummy half, and good yards there to be made. Alan Cairn making the tackle and forcing Hetherington back with the help of Kerrod Walters. Now Darren Britt gets a pass away. It was a good ball. Robert Relf, luckily for Brisbane, was grabbed by Kevin Walters, scooped away by Britt. It's gone on to Lamb. Lamb kicks. They're looking for Matthew Ryan. He's charging down the ground, but the ball beats them over the sideline.
You've really got to accommodate all the ball runners for Canterbury. They pass so close to the defence line. All their forwards willing to take the ball to the line and slip short passes. Terry Lamb, I don't think there was great communication there with Brett Dallas. He's the sort of player who can swoop on those short kicks.
A short passing game on the edge of the ruck against the Brisbane side has always worked against them. They don't seem to defend too well against those tactics, and the Bulldogs trying that today and having some luck.
Let's take a sideline comment from Steve Roach. Yes, Steve?
Yeah, how much pressure on Gavin Allen now, although he's a very experienced player with Glenn Lazarus off. He only played 20 minutes last week and hasn't played a full match in a long time.
So here's Brisbane making the mistake that the Bulldogs were hoping for. Terry Lamb tries to hurt them. Then Robert Relf, and across and through from Demick away for Ryan. And Ryan is tackled 15 metres out from the line. It's not over yet, though. This is the second tackle, and Ralph handles again. 5 metres out from the line. The Bulldogs, they got Brisbane now at sixes and sevens. Lamb's pass, it came away. It's gone on for Timo. Timo goes back in, tries to get it away, and Brisbane, I think, have got it. Knock-on has been ordered.
Both sides very willing to force out passes. Good one over the top there from Jim Dimmick. He's very, very skillful. This pass probably wasn't on from Timu.
Now, the Bulldogs. And Timu again, stepping off his right foot. Just inside the 20-metre line, he made a tremendous impact as he entered rugby league at the start of this year, John Timu. Craig Collar Mounter. 12 metres away from the Broncos' line. They work on a wide blind side, and Jim Dimmick tries to keep the arms free, and the Broncos mauling in over the top of the Canterbury lock forward. Hetherington, a long pass required. It finds Lamb. Lamb kicks. Now, here's a race. Hancock's been turned around. There's still a chance. Matthew Ryan, he scores. It's a try. The Bulldogs, they get their first.
It was just a great kick from Terry Lamb. The vision was sensational. He catches the ball, he frees it there. This player is the widest player for Brisbane, Michael Hancock. Look at the space. You've got a speed man coming down here in Brett Dallas. The bounce didn't favour Dallas, but Matt Ryan did a good job. Michael Hancock was the only one who really reacted. Steve Renoff took a long time getting across. He was just biding his time. I think that he had to get there quicker than he tried to. It was all left up to the Brisbane winger, and he just couldn't do it all.
Once again, we see a try being scored from a kick, and a beautiful kick from Lamb. And like yesterday, the bounce of the rugby league football produces many, many tries. It did yesterday. It's done it again right there.
Well, one thing about that try, it wasn't the fifth tackle either. It was early in the tackle count, as Peter Sterling said. Great vision from Terry Lamb. More than one way to skin a cat, I guess, and he thought, we'll go over the top of them. We're not going through them at the moment.
It was really poor reacting from everybody but Hancock. No one showed any great urgency in going across.
I just think it just caught him napping. They just realised it was over before they could do anything about it.
Now Halligan. 2 metres in from touch. 2 metres outside the 20. And a beautiful kick by Darryl Halligan. The flags are up, 1,016 points for Darryl Halligan in his career. 8 points to four now in favour of the Bulldogs. Here's the mistake.
Well, Brisbane started this game from the kickoff with basically 6-1 out runs. They got to halfway, that's when they lost Lazarus. They've got to maybe think of getting back to doing something like that a little bit more often out of their own danger territory. It's fine to attack from there, but you've got to be very specific when you do it. I just think Brisbane are probably overdoing it a little bit in their own danger ground.
Well, every time they've taken the ball forward, they've been met by Britton Pay. I think it's a little bit of an admission from Brisbane. They don't think they can go through Canterbury, and they don't think they can make the yards. Now that they've lost Lazarus, there seems to be a lack of confidence in their forwards. Wendell Saylor, not used to playing in the forwards at this level of football in semi-finals. A young front rower.
Darren Britt leading the way for Canterbury along with Dean Pay. And back on his own 20-metre line is Julian O'Neill. And look at this defence from the Bulldogs. They might have trailed early, but now they're in front and their confidence is high as Darren Smith tries to make a break against his old club. 23 metres out from his own line. Across now for Green. Just repeating, he was brought into the game very early by the unfortunate injury to Glenn Lazarus. And Steve Roach on the sidelines, you might be able to get an update on Glenn Lazarus. Is there any hope of him coming back? Maybe you've got that information now, Steve.
Yes, we have. It's a rib cartilage injury, and it won't be long before Lazarus is back. He's just waiting for the needles to take effect.
Thank you, Stephen. Here's Brisbane now going across for Alan Cairn. He's able to chop away from Dimmick.
Last tackle.
And he's taken it to ground on the last.
Yeah, that's cool play. I mean, Ken was on the fifth tackle when he got the football. He's just had a kick. I know he's not a noted kicker, but players at this stage of their careers have got to react in the big games, and he did not react at all.
Here's Dimmick. Dimmick very much leading the way for the Canterbury club, the Bulldogs. Hetherington now smothered into the ground by two Brisbane tacklers, including Alan Cairn. A question asked by Jason Hetherington of the referee as Darren Britt gets his arms free. Silver joins in from the back. Just a question mark on the pass. Allowed to go. Silver now prepares to play it. And that's where they are. They go right across for Lamb and on for Dimmick. He keeps it low. They turn Hancock around again. And Michael has been grasped in goal. Well, their kicking game is superb.
I think Michael Hancock talking to Julian O'Neill here. A little confusion at the back. They just balked each other. And that's why Hancock has stumbled into the in goal. He'd have probably stayed there. Had to call for the ball. Hancock probably running backwards. Felt as though it was his ball. Julian O'Neill came inside. That's caused him to get caught dead in goal.
This is a towering drop kick by Brisbane. Coming off his own 40-metre line. Now across the halfway is Polamalu. He bumps away initially from Darren Smith, who comes again to make the tackle with Willie Kahn. And now they go from the blind to the open for Simon Gillies.
You just get the feeling of Darren Britt or Dean Tay is going to get a ball away here shortly. Brisbane are really struggling around the rucks to contain these big men from unloading the ball. Dimmick, Britt, Tay are all doing the same. Canterbury really feeling they can get them through the middle here, I thought.
Well, there's the result of Dean Tay's effort. Robert Ralph has made a further deep incision. Now they kick again. He might have got it down. This could be another try. Watching as it is. The Dogs have got another.
Yeah, Matt Ryan, I think, is the try scorer. The kick was beautifully placed. The run from Matthew Ryan was very timely. Let's have a look. There's the kick there, definitely onside. Again, a little bit of confusion in behind the Brisbane front line. Ryan was very positive. He got to the ball. He wanted to get the downward pressure and did so.
And once again, you come back. They kicked early in the tackle count, the Doggies, and you come back to the mistakes made by Brisbane. Alan Cairn didn't get rid of the football on the fifth tackle. Wasn't completely his fault. It shouldn't have gone to him. But look at the delight on the faces of the Bulldogs.
Well, I think that try came from the previous kick. We mentioned that Julian O'Neill and Michael Hancock had balked each other a little. This time, both looked at the ball. They had enough people there. Both sort of came towards the ball, then balked. Matthew Ryan speared in, got in between the two of them, got the ball down. Fair try. O'Neill and Hancock really confused there over in that corner. You can see Julian O'Neill there.
Tremendous options, don't they? The Bulldogs in that kicking. That time, Dimmick rolling one through. Lamb can do it. So many players out there. They're very good at rolling it in. And you've got this sharpshooter having the extra 2 points. Definitely on a roll.
Hannigan about 8 metres in from touch, and look at he's doing to it.
Whoa. That was close.
Just making it go between the uprights. 14 points to 4. The Bulldogs on fire. Julian O'Neill. Once again, kicking down into that corner that can be a difficult corner with the sun where it is at the moment. And Hetherington comes it out just beyond the 20-metre line. Canterbury's into the ground. And Darren Britt now, 30 metres away from the Bulldogs' line on their first set of six since the restart. And Dean Pay is able to get a pass off Silver. They need quick hands. There's an overlap out here. Timu, he hesitated, goes back into the centre and links up with Dimmick. And Saylor is there to put him away with Green. Now, for Hetherington, for Lamb. Lamb kicks again. Dallas. Dallas, he might win the race for the ball. He gets a kick in. He gets a checkered passage. And it goes over the sideline. The touchy comes in.
Yes, Michael Hancock grabbed hold of the flying Dallas. Dallas did a marvellous job to keep the ball in play, and the kick was deliberately for him again. Terry Lamb drilling it through, got the bounce he wanted, was heading towards the sideline, put it on the toe. That
that's the...
Bulldogs have taken the quick tap.
They can't handle Canterbury's forwards, Brisbane.
Darren Britt plays it 12 metres out, across to Palomounta, on to Dimmick, held it back for Silva, and Darren Smith makes the tackle with Kevin Walters. Dimmick, a dummy half, he's all over the park. Now Dean Pay. Pay tries to go through Langer's tackle. He's pulled down 9 metres out, and the Bulldogs looking for their third try. Hetherington links up with Gillies, and Gillies is forced back. Madison and Walters make the tackle. They come wide on the left. Lamb's pass out in front of Dimmick. He got a tremendous pass away. That pass had a question mark. It's a penalty to Brisbane.
Oh, penalty they desperately needed too. They were under siege, the Brisbane side. Dean Pay's just steamrolling them along with Dimmick. What about that for a ball?
That is an unbelievable pass right here.
Very skillful player, Dimmick, and unfortunately the last pass went forward to a man in an offside position.
So Brisbane in a ton of trouble. Allen, 5 metres from the halfway line. This is Green crossing the halfway mark. It's through now from Madison, picking up Alan Cann. And Cann sees the 40-metre line on the Bulldogs' end of the park. Unfamiliar territory for Brisbane, really. This is Kerrod Walters now, skipping out from dummy half. Wendell Saylor takes the tackle. They go back to the centre. Kevin Walters picks up Terry Madison. Madison away for Renoff. He passes, and a Brisbane player dives at it, but a penalty's gone. And that was for holding Renoff off the ball.
There's some good ball play there from the Broncos. Through the middle of the ruck, Madison involved. Kevin Walters, little interchange of passing as they strode through.
That's what they're capable of, isn't it? Like all of a sudden they look down and out, but some individual brilliance coming to the fore. And they're a chance of running in some points here, and it's completely against the run of play.
Gavin Allen, 7 metres out from the line. They go over for Green. Another forward play, 2 metres out. Now they cut out Cann, go for Langer, then Saylor. But Terry Lamb came up very quickly. He put a punctuation mark in what Brisbane were doing. Played by Saylor, and now for Cann. And Cann is inside the 10-metre line. He's got a record of scoring tries in finals at the SFS. Played back for Kerrod to go away to Alan Langer. Then they go very much backward. Kevin Walters, he supplies Madison. His pass goes to ground off Darren Smith. And the advantage rule applies.
There you go, they look dangerous once again, the Brisbane side with the football, but they can't hang on to it for six. They just keep making mistakes. The big difference being the Bulldogs have yet to make a mistake in this match.
I think he's definitely playing injured, Alan Langer. I'll be surprised if he stays out there much longer. He's taking no part in this game. His defence is okay, but he hasn't run the ball at all. Normally in that situation, he'd have handled four or five times and probed at the line. He just can't get himself into the game, I feel, physically.
This is Dean Pay now, out on the 30-metre line. As the Bulldogs weather a storm. Here's Dimmick. He's into space again. Over the 40, over the 30, up to the 20. Helligan throws it in field. Came off Lamb, or did it come off Lamb, and into touch.
Well, talking of Alan Langer, he missed the tackle. So close a game for the Bulldogs. I've got to give a big rap to Julian O'Neill. He marshalled his defence. Dimmick looking for his runners. He's trying to position his winger. Throws the pass to Halligan. It was a fairly high one. It was well taken. O'Neill had to cover Dimmick and Halligan, and he did a great job in doing so. But the writing's on the wall for the Broncos. Great shot, that. Yeah, definitely came off the knee.
The pictures you're looking at are from the super slow-mo that we introduced into rugby league television last weekend, and hopefully we'll have two of those operating with our grand final coverage as the ball is played by Renoff and Brisbane work it away from their own 20 metre line. 28 metres out now from their own line, and Green is smashed by the Bulldogs defence. Gillies again is very busy along with Hetherington. Langer now takes it up to the line. If think those close to the Broncos camp would be the only ones that know how courageous these performances are from Alan Langer. Kerrod Walters now goes back and O'Neill puts it on the boot. He's had a busy day, Julian. Born in Sydney, Julian O'Neill. As Brett Dallas now comes back from that corner, and he of course is getting more work than Darryl Halligan. That is the corner that they love to attack.
Strong tackle there from Hancock. I've got a feeling that Julian O'Neill's afternoon is going to get busier.
It's Matthew Ryan, the scorer of two tries. Came in for Glenn Hughes. And Jason Smith, I'm led to believe, is getting ready. And of course there is a very strong argument that he is the best ball-playing forward in the Canterbury club. I certainly won't argue with that. Willie Kahn's got a minor problem, but Darryl Halligan hangs on and Willie Kahn plays the ball. Darren Smith sweeps it away to the only person available, and that was Julian O'Neill. Kerrod Walters now using his brother. His brother sprints almost into an opening. Renoff desperately looking for somewhere to go, and there's been a knock on. It'll be a Bulldogs feed, Bulldogs loose head, and is Renoff okay? Kevin Walters, that was him trying to get his try-scoring machine into space.
Jason Smith going on, looks as though Robert Relf is leaving the field, and Relf's had a marvellous first half. A lot of clean-up work, some strong charges. Terry Lamb feeds the scrum now. Dallas comes in off the wing to make an extra man and throws a pretty ordinary pass.
Silverman is put away 35 metres out from the Brisbane line. Here's Ryan taking it up to the 20.
If Brisbane were having trouble with the Canterbury forwards, they're going to have real trouble now. If this man's half right, he could really put the nail in the coffin for them. A tremendous ball player, and another one who can unload the ball at the line.
So Smith adds another dimension. They go over for Dallas. He puts it on the boot again. It'll beat them both, and it does. A race between Hancock and Dallas. Well, haven't they peppered Hancock's wing with kicks? Then a little jostle up in pursuit of the ball. You can do exactly what Michael Hancock was doing. Yeah, Jason Smith. What's that give them now of the established ball players? Dimmock, Pay, Smith, to mention but three. All equally capable of slipping a pass.
There's Gavin Allen leaving the field for the Broncos. Darren Lockyer has gone on, so there'll be a reshuffle as Kevin Walters is dumped by his opponent, Terry Lamb.
Now, Wendell Saylor. Meters short of the halfway mark. Go back now for O'Neill to clear. But he gets it to bounce just inside the field of play, but then crosses the line 10 metres out.
Well, they just cannot handle the Canterbury forwards, Brisbane, whether they've got the ball or without it. They're not making any yards. There isn't a forward in the Brisbane pack who's put his hand up and say, well, I've got to try and stem this tide. No one's coming up with any big hits. And Terry Lamb, he's relishing the fact that his side's really on top. Gives one there to his opposite number, Kevin Walters. He'll be feeling he'll be back again, Terry Lamb, next week. Right at this particular moment there. They're cruising Canterbury, I feel, at the moment.
You look at the stats and you see that Wendell Saylor leads the hit ups with 9. It tells a story, a back rower, no Lazarus. And Terry Madison hasn't hit the ball up in anger at all in the match. He's offloaded a couple of times through the traffic, but hasn't gone to ground as yet with the football.
This is Colomanta now on his own 20 metre line. And Dean Pay. Put down, 25 out from the Bulldogs line. Hetherington, realising that there's easy yards to be made from dummy half, accepts that invitation, and a knock on. So let's have a look at it. The Bulldogs, 2 tries to 1, and 14-4. Green got his head in the wrong place. Hetherington went to ground and lost the ball. Just under 5 minutes of the first half remaining, a half that has been very much with the Bulldogs, as Kevin Walters is taken to ground by Dean Pay. Now, Kerrod Walters, but look at this, one out stuff, oh, high tackle, Terry Lamb on Brett Green.
To his credit, Brett Green, he got straight up to it. He didn't lay down to overplay this. He copped a high shot, but the young fella got straight back up to his feet.
Alfie Langer decides to take the tap, as he often does. And Willie Kahn will play the ball 15 metres away from the Bulldogs' line. Kerrod Walters a dummy half. Off for Langer, then for Saylor. Saylor finds himself a target that's attracting a lot of attention today. It comes with notoriety as Kerrod Walters turns it in. Terry Madison flops it back. Saylor back. Langer. Langer gets it off. Kevin Walters on. Alan Cairn is with it. He flicks it out the back. It's still play on. And just inside the 20-metre line. It'll be played by Lockie up. They go off to the wide blind side. A rebound off Canterbury. They didn't play at the ball. And Green it is who'll play the ball for the Brisbane Broncos. Back on the 30-metre line. Langer. Langer. He's through. Pulled down. O'Neill. He's held. 9 metres away from the Bulldogs line. Fifth tackle. Kerrod Walters. Alan Langer. On it goes for Lockyer. And he's pulled down, and that's the turnover.
He's done some very good things out there this afternoon, Darryl Halligan. With exactly the right moment to come in off his wing and snuff out that attack. Alan Langer, the first time he's been able to run the football, made the bust. He almost got the feeling that they were prepared to let him run, but he couldn't do a great deal of damage. Tremendous outside defence on both sides of the field from the Dogs.
14-4 still, 2.5 minutes of the first half remaining. And a break down the right touchline from Brett Dallas. Across from Polamalu, it's into the hands of Darren Britt, who does the swivel in the tackle. Silver joins in. It goes away to Hetherington. Hetherington is tackled right on the halfway line from Terry Lamb. It's around behind Gillies and then Timu. And Timu was able to pass across to Jim Dimmock. Dimmock really playing strong today. Just brushed a couple of Brisbane Broncos away.
He's been touched by Willie Kahn in flight. Last tackle now. Jason Smith gets a dusty kick in, picked up by Lockyer.
Lockyer, 8 metres short of the halfway line. Across now for Langer, and it goes wide for Madison, then for Kevin Walters. Now for Renoff. Renoff gets it on for Hancock. He comes back in. Hancock is tackled on the 40-metre line. O'Neill up into the back line, steps away from one, taken in the second. Very close to half-time. 1.25 minutes left on the clock. Langer for Kerrod Walters. John Timu makes the tackle on the Brisbane hooker. Kerrod Walters now playing it back for Lockyer to scoop it away for Langer, then Saylor. And Saylor just outside the 20-metre line on fire. Playing it back for Lockyer, and Lockyer knocks it backwards at the play of the ball. It goes away for Langer. Langer, no, the referee has ordered a forward pass. So that'll be the turnover. It was the last tackle.
This has been wonderful defence by the Bulldogs. They're so determined to hold out this Brisbane side. Brisbane have started to look dangerous. That pass there from Kevin Walters was forward. They've gone wide a couple of times. They've looked dangerous. The Bulldogs defence has been super.
Jason Smith now, as the seconds of the first half tick away. Matt Ryan, scorer of both tries at the 17th and 22nd minute. Hancock got the first try for Brisbane at the third minute. But Ryan for the Bulldogs has got them both. Last couple of seconds, this is the last play. Jason Smith takes it ahead, looks to unload, but takes the tackle eventually. And the end of the first half, as I said, belonging very much to the Sydney Bulldogs. Two tries to Matt Ryan. Halligan
Mulligan has kicked 3 from 3. Hancock for Brisbane. He scored their lone points. Glenn Lazarus was injured in the opening minutes of the game, and that hasn't helped the Brisbane Broncos. Welcome back now to the Sydney Football Stadium. We're waiting for the teams to come back out, with the Sydney Bulldogs leading by 10 points over the Brisbane Broncos, 14-4 at halftime, 2-1. While the Bulldogs were playing brilliantly in the first half, the Brisbane Broncos, they were having no luck at all, with the injury to Glenn Lazarus happening early in the game. There's a chance he might be coming back. Let's have a look at the work rate meantime for both sets of forwards.
Terry Madison leading the tackle count there, but that's a disappointing hit up rate for him, just the one. Wendell Saylor, on the other hand, doing a lot of work, the former winger now playing in the back row, 11 hit ups. Great stuff by him. And Simon Gillies, Darren Britt leading the way in the tackling department for the Bulldogs. And Dean Clay, plenty of good stylish hit ups there from him.
I guess if you're a betting man, you'd like to think that your money was on Canterbury Bankstown. Everything going beautifully for them. Broncos on their way out now, just looking to see if there's any sign of Glenn Lazarus. Certainly not. And number 30 is still out there, Brett Green. Alan Langer turns. And Lockyer is out there. The second half about to get underway. It's the young man that was thrown early into the elimination semi-final. His biggest appointment in rugby league thus far. Kevin Walters. Torquay G'ing them up. Brisbane then, from right to left, they get us going into the second half, and Terry Lamb sends his youthful winger back, Brett Dallas. About 5 metres inside the 20-metre line, and now the forwards take over through a man that has really left an indelible stamp on the game already, Jim Dimmock. Dean Pay probably not far behind him, 30 metres away from their own line. They take the third tackle of Hetherington, and now they clear on an early tackle from Terry Lamb. Bounces favourably for Julian O'Neill. He comes back and beyond the 40-metre line. Steve Roach, what's the story particularly with Brisbane?
Yeah, well, Glenn Lazarus, they tried to noodle that area around the rib cartilage, but it was too big of an area and didn't take effect. They've taken him off to hospital now. They're a little bit worried about taking him home on the plane. But Brisbane are saying, look, Wayne Bennett's saying, look, there's nothing wrong with running the football on every occasion, but you must go forward first. They said they've got to spread a little bit more in defence. They're letting Canterbury get on the outside of them. He said, let's get some numbers in the tackles too and try and slow this Canterbury forward pack down. For the Bulldogs, he praised their defence. Chris Anderson, he thought they were outstanding in the first half. He just thought they tried to force a few passes in tackles. He said they've still got to do the hard work. There's a bit of yardage on the inside at many occasions too, so trail up there on the inside and don't rest on your laurels in the first half. Let's go on with it.
All right, Steve, and while you were summarising the dressing room activities, a shoulder charge by Simon Gillies saw Darren Lockyer cough up possession, and the Bulldogs are with it now. As Dimmock plays it just outside the 40-metre line, they work on the blind side for Darren Britt, and the big prop forward goes to ground right on the halfway mark.
He's really an unsung hero in this side, Simon Gillies. Tremendous work rate, skillful with the ball. Here he goes now, another hit up, taking it over the halfway line. He loves the hard yakker and he keeps putting his hand up for it.
Terry Lamb then pilots his ball down into the corner, where Michael Hancock is now confronted by Polamalu. He takes that tackle, offloads, and O'Neill now is tackled in the centre of the park
10 metres out from his own uprights.
Just talking about Simon Gillies and his endurance factor. A very, very good long distance runner, Simon Gillies. It comes out in his football with the amount of work he's able to get to. He's also the quickest forward in the game, I believe, at coming up in defence. He really gets off the line quickly and he can sprint that first 10 metres and be right in your face.
You're a pretty good long distance runner in your time, weren't you?
Yes. Wasn't really my go, Peter.
First ripple of trouble for the Bulldogs. Just watching this now, will obviously not have played the ball from Julian O'Neill, and it should have brought a penalty for the Bulldogs right in front of the uprights. Matthew Ryan has been injured. He's getting back on the defence line, but he's fallen out to the wing. Silva now back on his own 20-metre line.
Brisbane still having trouble with their kicking game. Julian O'Neill was not expecting that. I think that he believes that Darren Lockyer is out there to take over that responsibility. He didn't know the ball was coming. He had to do a little bit of fancy footwork to get the kick in. Mistake by Tumu, but it's gone backwards.
Tumu rounded up over there by Willie Khan. And the Bulldogs leading 14-4. Early minutes of the second half. About 9 metres short of the halfway mark now. Hetherington it is, who works it away for Dean Pay, and then Jason Smith. Smith taken by two Brisbane defenders, including Terry Madison. They come across for Polamalu to step out of the tackle of Lockyer. Dallas on his outside. He might have passed too soon. Infield kick. Terry Lamb's after it, but Darren Smith. That's fantastic.
Well, that had try written all over it. You know, Terry Lamb was going to get to that football as Polamalu got through the Lockyer tackle and then put the foot down, put plenty of pace on. Great kick from Dallas. They're all onside. Lamb thought he was going to score a try, but Darren Smith, what a beauty.
Great save by Darren Smith for the Broncos. He brings us back 35 metres out from the Broncos line as Alan Tan hammers play up towards the halfway line. This is Madison offloading for Green. Green goes straight, runs into the shoulder of Dean Pay. Gill was saying if you run at the right shoulder of Pay, you deserve to suffer. He hits and hits like a hammer. Green, 35 out from the line on the last tackle for Lockyer to go off the left foot. It's a high kick, it's gone right across the ground, and it's come down with the Bulldogs winger, Darryl Halligan. Plays it just beyond his own 20-metre line, and Jason Smith goes out. And that's the ball coming on down into the chest of Darryl Halligan on that slow-mo camera.
Brisbane playing without any real spring in their step at the moment. It's as though they're just waiting for the end to come. Fairly courageous, so you've got to understand that a lot of these players out there are playing with injuries that would keep normal players out. I'd say the fact that it's only a semi-final is the reason they're out there.
28 is Mitch Newton preparing to come on as Terry Lamb puts a kick down behind Michael Hancock and it finds the line 12 metres out from the Brisbane try line. 14-4 and almost 6 minutes gone in the second half.
The trend, the game with the way the trend's going, any other side in the competition would be saying this is over. It's only a matter of playing out the minutes and Canterbury will go on to the next week. But Brisbane, they can strike back very, very quickly. Individually, they've got so many great players and Canterbury will just have to concentrate right to the end to make sure they put this win away. That'll help.
So the Dogs have won against the feed. Polamalu's got it away to Ryan and Ryan is held about 5 metres out from the Brisbane line. Not the first time they've done that against Brisbane. Now Terry Lamb, and he's taken to ground 5 metres out again. Hetherington looking around, looking for Polamalu. Polamalu way off to the left. There he is. He pushes it on, and then it comes back infield, and it's Simon Gillies. Through Jim Dimmick, on for Craig Polamalu. Polamalu put down. 9 metres out from the Brisbane line. The Bulldogs, they can smell victory as it goes to Hetherington. He's put away. 5 metres out still from the line. Now across for Pay. Jason Smith ran the decoy and Pay is put down. They've actually lost some ground under the Brisbane defence. This is the last. Terry Lamb, he gets his kick in and Khan. Will he get back into the field of play? Willie Khan is put down, forcing the line dropout.
It's just very good finals play here from the Bulldogs. Very methodical. Kick from Lamb was a good one. Willie Khan headed back centre field, thought there might have been a space there, but all of a sudden six Bulldog jerseys appeared. And you cannot afford to lose a scrum against the feed at this level of football. And again, in fact, no Lazarus there, rookie front rowers don't help.
So Silva taking play back down towards the 30-metre line. Ball played by Jim Dimmock. Now Darren Britt. Brisbane asked to weather another attacking raid. Can they repel it again? It's out with Ryan, who has scored two tries so far. Then he gets the pass away. Palomata. Palomata gets it on, and wide on the ground is Silva. Silva plays it, Timu passes, and then it comes away through Hetherington for Lamb, around the back for Gillies, and Gillies is taken in the defence of Renoff. 20 metres out from the Brisbane line. They work on the blind side, through the boot of Dimmock. Hancock gets a pass away. O'Neill falls on it, but Manson rules it went forward from Hancock.
Oh, can you believe that? Hancock did the right thing. Nice little take here on his own line. Got confronted by the good chase defence and decided to throw a pass.
So the Bulldogs, at the end of this, will have something like 15 tackles in possession inside the 20-metre line. Played by Timu. Silva gives it away to Ryan. And Ryan trying to stay in touch at the moment or stay in the field of play. Put away eventually by Darren Smith. That's Darryl Halligan. And now Jason Smith, and he's not held inside the 10-metre line. Hetherington! 2 metres out from the line. Jason Smith goes into dummy half. Hetherington pushed back to the ground. Now wide for Lamb. Wider for Dimmock. And Dimmock held there by Lockyer. The ball wasn't raked out. Yes. Penalty goes to the blue and whites.
And despite all the pressure that the Bulldogs are able to mount here, you'd still feel as though they'll kick for goal. Yes, Halligan coming across. They'd have been tempted to take the tap because there's been 16 tackles that they've had against this defence and had to get close to breaking open. It's an important kick because it will put the side two converted tries clear.
Scored two tries from kicks, Canterbury. In the course of the top 10 or so sides in the Premiership, they've scored less tries than any side this year. Canterbury rely very heavily on Darryl Halligan's kicking boot. A lot of tackles there down on the Brisbane line. Brisbane very tired and playing with a lot of injuries, still able to hold them out. Kick for goal, always the option for Canterbury.
Darryl Halligan with a perfect record in this match. And from 19 metres out, he strikes it yet again sweetly. So the Bulldogs go further in front. They lead 16 points to 4, 51 minutes gone.
Monday night.
Back for the restart off the boot of Julian O'Neill one more time. Dallas coming out of the scoreboard corner. He's tackled 20 metres out now. 16 points to 4, as Peter Sterling pointed out. The Bulldogs, two converted tries in front. As Darren Britt puts it out towards the 30-metre line. First set of 6 for the Sydney Bulldogs since the addition of the 2 points off the boot of Darryl Halligan. And Dean Pay will play it now. 12 metres his side of halfway. This is Jason Smith. He runs into the shoulder of Brett Green. Kieran Walters was underneath, and now the last tackle coming up, and Terry Lamb He kicks, it goes awkwardly, but it goes between fullback and centre, or fullback and winger. And here's O'Neill coming across the park and making himself a pretty easy target. Now it's with Khan. Khan gives a short pass. Lockyer finds himself in space. Goes inside Terry Lamb. He picks up Renoff. Renoff's got Hancock with him. Tackled by Darrell Halligan. Now Hancock. Hancock. The ball goes out for Langer. Langer. Back it goes for Walters. Walters on for Khan. Khan gets it on for O'Neill. O'Neill. He can see the try line. He's pulled down. 2 metres away. Langer. Langer taken by the Bulldogs defence. 16-4. 10 metres out from the line. From Kieran Walters to his brother Kevin. They go to the blind side for Willie Khan to be tackled by John Timu and Jason Smith. There's the corner post. That's how close they are. Now the kick across the ground from Darren Smith. They go up for it. This could be a try. No. Ruled the ball, went forward. No try to Brisbane.
Brett Dallas gets out from dummy half. A quick restart. Lockyer swooped on the ball. The referee has seen a little knock on there, and there's another one. Broncos are getting back into this game.
Get away! Get away! Get away!
Great tackle on the far side from John Timu and Darrell Halligan. It's been a tremendous battle between the wingers out there this afternoon. Halligan and Dallas have been outstanding for the Bulldogs. Khan and Hancock have done some great work for the Broncos. They've taken the quick tap, Saylor centre field.
It's Kevin Walters now. Back for his captain, and Langer tries to dance his way through, but he's wrapped up by Jason Hetherington in the main. And Walters now for Lockyer. Lockyer thinks about coming back on the inside for Wendell Saylor. Saylor looked like he might have just dropped off. Now they come across for Gavin Allen. And Allen is put down 10 metres away from Canterbury's line. Canterbury leading by 12. They come out to Madison. Then I thought Walters was through. Here's Renoff. Renoff. Is he over? Is he able to get it down? He's been ruled short. Bottom half of the body was over, but the torso wasn't. Kieran Walters for Alan Langer. Langer gets a one-hander away through Alan and Walters. Timu touches the ball. No, he's ruled five tackles. Well, I thought John Timu got a touch to it. Walters kicks. There's a race on in the corner. A bad bounce. Brisbane! Brisbane! They score! Darren Smith! Darren Smith! Against his old club.
Never write them off. Just when you think they're gone, they come up with something. I thought that that was a big call against them. It looked as though Timu had touched the ball. Paul Borton spoke about wicked bounces, and that was a horror one for Rod Silver and Darren Smith, who's played well this afternoon. He swooped. Good kick from Wallace into open space.
Well, there you go. Four tries from four kicks. And the Broncos, it all started, you know, about 3 or 4 minutes ago when Darren Lockyer made a break. And they ran 60, 70 metres, and since then they put all the pressure on the Bulldogs. And, of course, a mistake made by Matthew Ryan coming out from his own line, dropping the football. And the Smiths ecstatic.
Talking about that Darren Lockyer break, it was great work from Willie Khan. He actually threw the pass, opened up a hole. He had to come from the far wing to get involved. As you say, that really started things going for them. They got some momentum, a couple of sets of six, a penalty went their way. Also a mistake from the Bulldogs. Pretty much the first one we've seen them commit in their own 20-metre area.
Tremendous work by Kevin Walters too. I mean, that was a bad call against them. John Timu had touched that ball. They should have got six again. It was a heads-up play. He just got on with it. He didn't worry about something he couldn't control. Fifth tackle, let's put the ball in the end goal and see if we can get a result. That's exactly what they got.
Very important kick, this one.
He's about 15 metres in from touch. 18 metres out, strikes it, and he's got it. That brings them back to within six. 16-10, 57th minute.
Tuesday.
Starting this next passage of play. First tackle on the restart of play. Darren Lockyer it was. That was a suspect pass from dummy half for Gavin Allen. Brisbane starting to come back. 16 to 10 down. Green has lost it. Well, that's a bad mistake, and you can thank the quality of the tackle, and I believe it was Jason Smith.
Yeah, he comes in on the blind side. Knocks the ball. Just the impact.
Would have to think if the Bulldogs score next, they will go on and win this semi-final.
Well, I'd be thinking field goal, Ray. I know that they've been down here and exerted a lot of pressure, but the other mob now, Brisbane, have got to within one converted try. All of a sudden, they'd have to score twice again. I think psychologically, it would be a blow.
Hetherington playing it just outside the 20-metre line. Here's Darren Britt.
Terry Nairs positioned himself just for that. He's talking to his players.
Jason Smith. This has probably been the best performance I've seen all year from the Bulldogs. Here's Lamb. He goes on for Polamalu and wide for Timu. I think Rod Silver was meant to be there. He was a little bit behind the play. Now Lamb across and high. Underneath it is Renoff. Renoff has got it for Brisbane. Well, the pressure release valve comes off. Come. 16 to 10, an hour of the game is gone. We go up and come down with Steve Renoff. Incredible camera, that clarity of the shots. 25 metres out now from the Brisbane line. They're trailing 16 to 10. And will we still have that appointment here next Sunday between Canberra and Brisbane?
That's a very unusual kick, that one. No pressure at all on Silver. He catches the ball on the halfway line. It's a midfield bomb with no chases. Straight away, they're under pressure in defence again.
Matthew Ryan.
It's the experience factor I'm talking about, Sterling, Young, Lockyer, Brett Green. They're good players, but both of them have come up with poor plays in the last couple of minutes under pressure. And that's where Brisbane are losing out, I feel, across the park.
Now, Brisbane have only got 12 in the line. Madison is down on the ground. He's up now, trying to get back for 10. Terry Lamb, he pumps it out. It's Dimmock, away for Timu. And Timu is grassed out there. Good work by Darren Smith. Now it's a cross, and Dimmock goes for the drop goal. Doesn't look too bad, but it's just wide, and back to the 20-metre line for the restart.
They could have got in better position for that. Tough angle for Jim Dimmock. He didn't miss by much, but it wasn't the last tackle. He just apologised to his teammates there. I think he took the wrong option. They are really struggling, Brisbane, to get out of this area. There's no drive there at all. That was the injury to Terry Madison, which left him with only 12 in the defensive line.
Poor old Terry Madison is one of the last players that needs to take another hit. High up, here's Darren Smith trying to hold Timu away with one arm. Looking to get a pass inside for Willie Khan. Through Walters to Saylor. Saylor fends off from one. The ball goes to ground. Hands by O'Neill. Six more tackles, says Manson. It's with Renoff. Renoff is held. He gets the pass away. Hancock is with it. Hancock goes back and away from Terry Lamb. The referee says no obstruction. Play on.
It's really dangerous, the Brisbane side. They're not being put on the ground.
Now Gavin Allen promotes back for Hancock. Hancock going across to the right, trying to stampede over the top of Jim Dimmock and Darren Britt. Kerrod Walters away for Langer, then for Cam. And Cam taken up the top by Timu, underneath by Robert Ralph. And Brisbane find themselves 8 metres now into Bulldogs territory.
through the halves. It comes out to Madison. A short pass to Lockyer. Finds itself with the Bulldogs. Well, the handoff to Dallas finds the flying winger away. Pulled down from behind. There was a suspect pass there. By the same token, the pass to Dallas. Now it's with Darren Britt. And Britt has pulled down 32 metres out. 16 to 10. I've got a question mark on the handoff of the ball to Brett Dallas at the start of all of this. Dimmick plays it now. 25 out. Ralph, as he normally does, goes in just the one direction, and that's straight ahead. Robert Ralph, the second row forward. Terry Lamb sets himself for the drop goal. Touched in flight, and it comes down for Julian O'Neill. And he's rounded up by Craig Connell-Mounter. 12 metres out from the Brisbane line. They're trailing by six. Steve Reynolds. 16 and a half minutes to go. And Brisbane 6 points in arrears. Raging hot favourites to win this match today. Renoff, he puts Langer through a gap. He hasn't got the pace. 45 metres out from his line. Kerrod Walters, he uses Madison. Madison has tackled.
He's got a chance on the far side.
Now Kerrod Walters, he goes to the right. Kevin Walters is with him. He passes now, and they run out of support on the inside. Five tackles gone. Lockyer on for Langer. Langer kicks across the field, but the chasers, well, they're arriving now. Silva has been driven down by Saylor.
Oh, they arrived in the form of Wendell Saylor, full steam ahead, and that's a great play by him. The Broncos, they're looking very dangerous now, putting some passes together. The Bulldogs look as though they're starting to tire. And this bounce set up nicely for Silva, but look at Saylor.
That could be one of the biggest tackles of the game. Alan Langer just wanted to get it in there because he saw that they hadn't reacted that well, the Bulldogs, in getting back to cover the kick. Another six now.
Darren Britt is off and Mitch Newton has gone on as Brisbane come back to answer the dropout from Darryl Halligan. And it is Julian O'Neill, 35 out from the Canterbury line. Played back for Madison and then on for Darren Smith, who's done some exciting things for Brisbane today.
Yeah, their backs have played really tough this afternoon. The likes of Renoff, Smith, the two wingers, of course. I think Hancock's had a great game.
Now John Plath. Bring it back for Kerrod Walters, who's running more and more. He flops the pass back for Plath, and then they try and squeeze the pass. Manson said no knock on. Here's a try for Khan. Willie Khan scores for mine. I think the touch judge is saying, yes, it's a try. He's standing in the end goal, and he's ruled forward. Well, I can't believe the touchy. When they stand in the end goal, they're saying it's a try. If he thinks it's not, they normally stand outside in the field of play.
I think the touch is telling him there's a knock-on back right there, which Manson missed. Manson missed. He thought it came off the boot. Now, that he's got that down, but he's ruled there's been a knock-on. And there was.
And that's a fair call, Paul, but the touch judge standing in the in goal, in touch in goal, is indicating by his mere presence there that he thinks it's a try.
Well, okay, his positioning might be wrong, but at least we've come up with the right call.
Oh, no question about it. I thought there was a knock-on originally, and Manson indicated that it came off the feet. That's why we went with the play. Price is on for pay. Newton now tackled 40 metres out from the Bulldogs' line. Now Lamb. Terry guiding the Bulldogs into port. Well, that's a good tackle. That's called a cannon. This is Platt.
Terry Lamb realising how important field position is now for the last 13 minutes in this game. We've got five Brisbane players still coming back on side, and this is the second tackle. This is the end of the field the Bulldogs want to be.
Langer goes wide with Lockyer. Lockyer, goal! Knocked down by Canterbury backwards, and Dallas is with it now for them. 16 to 10, 67 minutes gone. Price. 11 out from the line. Hetherington. Dimmick. Newton off of the decoy. Dimmick goes to the 10-metre line.
Bulldogs. A couple more, maybe one more shot, then back to the centre of the park. Where again they might set for the drop goal. Here they come for Silva. And Dimmick gets a one-hander on. They've got the numbers. Surely they'll make it. Yes, they'll make it. Gillies. Gillies. He scores. The Bulldogs. 20 points to 10.
Well, that should wrap it up. They weren't thinking field goal. They could sniff a try coming on. And there's the jubilation amongst the fans. Simon Gillies throws a little dummy at the end. He doesn't get many. This was the mistake. Darren Lockyer just looking to do too much. Robert Ralph knocked it backwards. And a couple of tackles later, they create an overlap. Some beautiful hands on the inside here. This pass now, as we freeze it there, that pass has opened up a 4-on-1 overlap. Plenty of support out here as play continued. It was just a simple get the ball out wide. The pass not thrown by Gillies. The dummy thrown, and Hancock, he just had too much to do. This next pass was the one that set up the try. That ball there.
And that was very poor positional defence there by the Brisbane side. They had all their numbers over on one side of the field and no one out here. And well read by the Bulldogs. Simple matter of getting the football out there.
Tim Dimmick has really isolated himself on Alan Langer all day. We've seen him run through his tackles a couple of times, but almost every time he runs the ball to the line, he's looking for Langer, realising he's not tall enough to wrap Dimmick up. And Dimmick very adept at getting the ball away. Straight to Langer, held the ball out, created the overlap Peter Sterling spoke of. And Jim Dimmick has really stamped his authority on this game. I think he's been Canterbury's best.
Well, what a call at the other end on Willie Kahn.
Don't get me wrong, I think David Manson thought that it came off the feet. And look at Halligan. Has there been a better kicking performance in a match of this stature? 22 to 10 now. 69 goal. Well, Brisbane have resorted to the shallow restart. And Newton. Big Mitch Newton. He's carried a pretty big part of the year on his shoulders for Canterbury. 70th minute. And Stephen Price. Alan Langer has succumbed to that injury. And with Alan off the field, does that coincide with the white flag?
Well, they never put up a white flag. I think it's just an indication that it's been a courageous performance from Alan Langer to get through 70 minutes.
Here's Julian O'Neill. Pulled down by Simon Gillies. Great to see Simon Gillies get a try. He put in a tremendous effort here last weekend. And he's done it again today. He's topped the tackle count with 27. And he's the second top hit-up player in the Bulldogs forward line. So Simon Gillies rewarded with a try in the elimination semi-final this afternoon. 22 points to 10. 8.5 minutes of time remaining. And Terry Lamb, the great Terry Lamb, he just keeps coming on. We thought he was gone last week. We thought he was bound to go today. But Terry refuses to be lowered. Wayne Bennett.
Well, he's back for another week, Barbar. I don't think Brisbane have been travelling well all season. They've run up some big scores against the lesser sides, but to my mind, they haven't reached the heights they have in previous years. I didn't think last week's performance against Canberra was all that good. The closeness of the scores probably made the quality of the game, but compared to the other semi-finalists, I thought that Brisbane were down on previous form, and Canterbury have rammed that home today. Very strong forward display from Canterbury. Outmuscled the Brisbane six. And Brisbane, a lot of players out there now with their jerseys hanging out. They're just waiting for the siren.
Yeah, a month ago I thought Brisbane were no chance, but I was turned around a little bit by the display of their forwards over the last couple of weeks. And that really was all coming back in many ways to the form of Glenn Lazarus. That's been, I think, the biggest impact on this game. Apart from that kind of defence from the Bulldogs, no Lazarus for most of the game.
Oh, the crowd applauding. Another very big hit by the Bulldogs. Brisbane losing the ball. Brett Green it was, another of the new boys who will realise after today, as will Darren Lockyer, that this is just up another rung on the ladder.
Yeah, he's not a bad player, Brett Green, youngster up and comer, but he needs to learn to run with a bit of agility and flexibility in his body, or else he'll keep losing the ball like that all the time.
Agility and flexibility.
Here's Gillies now, just inside the 20-metre line. 6 3/4 minutes to go. 6 3/4 out from full-time as it's 11 on 11.
The field goal was going to be the option, but it's going to be a penalty, which will really wrap it up now. Alan Cairn told to go low, shake of the head. And Halligan, who'd moved in to take the field goal, will now get an opportunity to go 1 point better. 14-point lead. No good arguing. Terry Madison disappointed with the decision as well. Robert Rolfe down receiving attention.
It was a great performance today by the Bulldogs. I thought that Brisbane's strike power would be too much for them, but the likes of Sale and Renoff haven't really come into the game. They've been bustled out of it by a good, strong Bulldogs defence. Some great goal kicking by Darryl Halligan.
How many? Robert Rolfe. Stunned by that tackle from Alan Cairn as Darryl Halligan raises the flags yet again. 24-10. The Bulldogs. They played the grand final against Canberra last year. And now they get a chance one more time. Maybe not at the grand final, but a chance to upset Canberra's plans.
There are a lot of people thinking that we're going to see the same teams line up next week as we saw a couple of weeks ago. Manly up against Cronulla, Canberra up against Brisbane. It hasn't worked out that way. The Knights and the Bulldogs have won a spanner in the works there. A good contest coming up Saturday and Sunday next week. Not the ones that a lot of people expect.
I've got to say to you, Phil Gould, that coming into the match today, I hadn't been impressed with Canterbury's form through the season. I thought they would lose this one today, but their form today, if they can reproduce that against Canberra, it mightn't be the open and shut case that many people think it is. Ryan down the right flank, looking for number three. The pass goes in field and down to the Broncos.
Yeah, well, Canterbury, another one that has struggled during the season, but I just like the fact that Jason Smith was going to be back today. Dimmick, Smith and Kay, that's the nucleus of their side in previous great performances, and it's getting back to that. One thing about Canberra, they will not enjoy playing Canterbury because they don't enjoy those sides that do get up very quickly in their face in defence. I know they beat them fairly comfortably in last year's grand final, but Canterbury did have a semi-final win against them in a lead up to the grand final. And, this will make Canberra nervous, the form that Canterbury has shown today.
Yeah, Canterbury playing below their best might not have represented a threat to Canberra, but with their big guns back, with that tremendously talented back row, we are set for another magnificent match between the two seeds, Canberra and Canterbury. And I make no apology for calling them that either. I know that officially they are the Sydney Bulldogs, but I think their fans would prefer them to be known as the Canterbury Bulldogs. This is Darren Smith unloading for Lockie. Lockie tries to pop a pass. In the circumstances, why not? Dallas is tackled. Just inside the 30-metre line. As Lamb goes across for Silver to find Gillies, and Gillies is put away on the 30-metre line.
And as the curtain comes down on the Brisbane Broncos for 95, we say goodbye to Terry Madison, who's heading to the London Broncos. He's had a very good career with, first of all, Easton and then Brisbane for the last, 8 years?
Lamb there. Still focused on what has to be done. Time, though, has got Brisbane well and truly beaten. They had a chance. on that disallowed try for this man, Willie Calm. It was a touch judge call. And there'll be a lot of talk about it long after this match is finished. David Manson indicated that the ball had came off the feet, but then from what we can gather, he was overruled by his touch judge two plays later on.
Yeah, big call. It goes from a possible, 16-all to 22-10 a couple of minutes after that. But I think in the end, they got it right, which is the main thing.
This new top eight semi-final series has produced some great football. Majority of the game sudden death ones. We don't see many second chances at this in this type. And I think what it is going to produce is the two season's best teams, Manly and Canberra, in the grand final. I think that's the way it should be.
Here's Ralph up the centre, 40 metres out.
Nick Hancock over the sideline.
Got a hemming as he was trying to keep that ball in play.
Knock on against Robert Ralph. There's a problem here for Michael Hancock.
To win a premiership, you've got to have a lot of things go right for you. You've got to do a lot of things right over a long period of time, and you've got to have luck with injury when the important games come around at the end of the year. Brisbane, unfortunately, just haven't had that luck this season. It's been with them in previous years, not this year. Lazarus, a big loss. Langer, obviously, playing injured today. A lot of young fellas in their side who gain from the experience. They'll be disappointed today, but a good summer and another preparation, they'll be back again next year. And Brisbane start to rebuild after what was a tremendous era for them.
Just looking at the performance of Matthew Ryan today, even with Glenn Hughes fit, I wonder would Chris Anderson tamper with the side that ran on today. This is Dallas with just a matter of seconds remaining. Hancock assisted from the Sydney Football Stadium. Mitch Newton takes the last tackle, surely. With Canterbury Banks down, the Bulldogs defeating Brisbane 24 points to 10 in front of a crowd of probably in the mid-30,000s, 3 tries to 2, 24 points to 10.
Last year's grand finalists, the Sydney Bulldogs, have issued their challenge a very strong win here at the football stadium over Brisbane, 24 points to 10. They were tough physically and mentally, a lot of good performers. The man we chose as their best is now with Steve Roach.
Well, the Ansett Australia $1,000 man of the match goes to Jimmy Dimmick. Jimmy, congratulations. Outstanding performance from the Bulldogs forward pack. They were outstanding today.
Yeah, definitely. We knew they were going to play in the forwards, and we knew it was going to be a tougher game this week, and it sure was. And our forwards stood up to theirs. We hit them all day. We were just trying to attack their attack, and it worked for us.
You'd have to pay tribute to the Broncos. Went in with a lot of injuries. A good performance from them too.
Yeah, they've got a great side there. You know, all their players are great players. And, you know, we couldn't, like, focus on one player like Alfie. We knew if he was going to be out, it didn't matter to us. We all knew they were great players.
Well, the Doggies' form hasn't been that good. It's been a bit scratchy this season. What's been the turnaround the last 2 weeks? Sudden death matches.
Yeah, I think, like, you play all season and you play good during the season, and it doesn't mean much if you don't play good in the semi, so we're trying to get our act together now.
Well, Jimmy, congratulations on behalf of Ansett.
All right, thanks, Channel 9 and Ansett. Thanks a lot.
One of the most creative players in the game was great again this afternoon. Footy Tab, a couple of underdogs getting up this weekend. Pick the score, 394.90, 12.75 for pick the winners, and over $900 pick the margins. And next weekend, the first qualifying final on Saturday, a replay of last year's grand final, Canberra up against the Bulldogs. And on Sunday, Manly up against Newcastle. And Fatty, not really the lineups that people expected.
No, they're not, Pete, but the standard of football has been top class during all of the semi-finals. It'll be a beauty next weekend. One heck of a weekend of football. At this stage, I've got to tip Manly and Canberra, the two favourites. But, you know, there's been some upsets so far, and they could continue.
Yeah, that's got to be a big advantage having this week off. But a tremendous performance here from the Sydney Bulldogs, 24 to 10. And from the Sydney Football Stadium, on behalf of the entire team, I wish you a very good night.